It gives me great pleasure to welcome Johan Pleymers, Lead Product Manager, Developer Experience. Johan, welcome.
Yes. Welcome, Louis. Thank you.
Tell me a little bit what you're going to be sharing with us about the OT2 Workflow Service.
Yeah, so I want to give you a quick demo of the workflow modeler. We'll import an existing workflow, explore the different activities a bit, and with that, I'll show you what it's capable of.
That's great. Let's jump into the demo.
Yeah. So Claire already showed us how to create an application in Developer Console. I've also created mine. Here we see the different services that are available to the developer. And for the Workflow Service, we have the designer. So let me open the designer. That brings us to the modeling environment in which we can also import and export a model. So let me import a model that we've already created, which is workflow for a simple contract approval process. And this process, we'll see as the workflow starts, we first need to load the contract details from the CMS service, which is done by giving it a contract ID and then just doing a call to the contract service, loading the object from which we will check the value of the contract that is given for review. If the value is below 1,000, we will do an automatic approval. Otherwise, we create a user task for the manager to review the contract and then either react or approve the contract. In both cases, we'll update the CMS object with a simple call to update the status property. Then in the end, we will send an email with the current status of the review. So sending an email, again, is as simple as creating an email in Outlook by specifying the to and the subject and the body. And in this case, we also use some of the workflow properties in the email we sent. So if we then have a look at the other activities. So we already saw the user task, mail task. We also have the HTTP task, which can be used to integrate with your external REST services like SAP or Salesforce or any other content task, signature, and you name it. So once you're done with updating the workflow, you can export it again either as JSON or as XML. Then download it to your computer or copy it to your clipboard. From where you can deploy it again in your OpenText tenant. And with that, I conclude the demo.
Great, great demo. Thank you, Johan.